Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about previous year questions in PGIMER. B cell antigens are CD19 and CD20 are the B cell antigens. True about oncogene. True about proto-oncogene. Proto-oncogene is only found in virus. False, it is found in our cells also, in human cells also. They are actually normally present in humans also. They are only found in malignant cells? No. Normally involved in cell cycle proliferation. True. They can be converted into oncogene? Yes. On mutation, it causes cancer. True. Proto-oncogene on mutation causes cancer. Next question. Thrombosis is predisposed by? So protein S is an antithrombotic factor. So thrombosis is predisposed by protein S deficiency, antiphospholipid antibody syndrome. Because in antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, there are antibodies which will cause thrombi in the blood vessels. Then in homocystinuria, this will predispose to predispose to arterial and venous thrombosis. So thrombosis is predisposed by protein S deficiency, antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, and homocystinuria. Next question. Pancytopenia occurs in Kala Azar. There will be pancytopenia, and pancytopenia is also seen in hairy cell leukemia. Pancytopenia is seen in Kala Azar and hairy cell leukemia. We see pancytopenia. Non-small cell lung cancer is associated with KRAS, epidermal growth factor receptor, and also P53. Non-small cell lung cancer is associated with KRAS, epithelial growth factor receptor, and it is also associated with P53. True about carotid body tumor is, carotid body tumor is slow growing tumor. True. It is mostly benign. Yes. It is mainly unilateral, not bilateral, and carotid body tumor is capsulated. So carotid body tumor is slow growing, capsulated, unilateral, and benign. Next question. Which of the following is true about autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease? Except. So all are true except some false. So many patients in autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, or it is also called as adult polycystic kidney disease, many patients may be asymptomatic till third or fourth decade. True. In autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, many are asymptomatic. In autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease, you will see that they will be present even in infancy. Pancreatic cysts are seen in it, associated with hypertension. True. Subarachnoid hemorrhage is the most common extrarenal manifestation. Actually, most common extrarenal manifestations is not subarachnoid hemorrhage. It is actually liver cysts. Cysts in the liver are the most common extrarenal manifestation in autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease. Next question. Which of the following is not a feature of reversible cell injury? So, microvilli disruption is a feature of reversible cell injury. Endoplasmic dilatation, true. Disintegration of plasma membrane. Once plasma membrane is disintegrated, it goes to irreversible cell injury. Nuclear lysis is also irreversible cell injury. Myelin figures are seen in reversible cell injury, but their number increases in irreversible cell injury. So, in irreversible cell injury, you see disintegration of plasma membrane and nuclear lysis. Next question. Red infarct occurs in venous occlusion. Yes, In lung there is dual blood supply, so as a result there is red infarct is seen. Organs with dual blood supply like small intestine, true, you will see red infarct. Ovarian torsion. In ovarian torsion also you will see red infarct. Seen in solid organs supplied by end arteries. If it is supplied by end arteries, you will see white infarct, not the red infarct. Next question. Fibrolamellar carcinoma of liver. In fibrolamellar carcinoma of liver, true is, it is common in old age. No, it is seen in young age, 20 to 40 years. It is associated with cirrhosis. No, it has no associated with cirrhosis, not associated with hepatitis B virus. Good prognosis than hepatocellular carcinoma. It has good prognosis than hepatocellular carcinoma. Next question. Which of the following is true about prothrombin time? Prothrombin time SSS extrinsic pathway. True. Prothrombin time is increased in liver disease. In liver disease, prothrombin time is increased because prothrombin is produced from the liver only. It is decreased in vitamin K deficiency. Actually, in vitamin K deficiency also, it is almost normal actually. Prothrombin time is normal from vitamin K deficiency. See, it is increased in liver disease because whenever there is liver disease, there will be deficiency of production of clotting factors. So, mainly the prothrombin time will denote the clotting factors. So in liver disease they are decreased, there is deficiency of clotting factors, so obviously prothrombin time is increased. It is almost normal in vitamin K deficiency. Normal value of prothrombin time is not 2 to 4 minutes. It is not. So answer is SSS extrinsic pathway and increased in liver disease. Next question. True about thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura is, in thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, indirect hyperbilirubinemia, true, because of many thrombi formation, that is destruction of RBC, hemolysis. Hemolysis always is related to indirect hyperbilirubinemia. Spirocytosis with thrombocytopenia. Spirocytosis are not seen. Cystocytosis with thrombocytopenia, true. Cystocytosis are seen. Thrombi formation is also seen in thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. Next question. In which of the following disease, antinuclear cytoplasmic antibodies are not found? So, not found. Antinuclear cytoplasmic antibodies are not found. They are found in polyarteritis. See, no, they are not found in polyarteritis nodosa. Actually, neutrophilic anti-cytoplasmic antibodies are found in vaginous granulomatosis, that is you will see C. ANCA, whereas Churg-Strauss disease you will also see ANCA is seen in Churg-Strauss disease also, I think. Okay, you will see it, ANCA is seen, it is P. ANCA is only seen in Churg-Strauss disease. And even in microscopic polyangiitis also you will see P. ANCA. ANCA is not seen in polyarteritis nodosa and Behçet's disease. Antineutrophilic cytoplasmic antibodies are not seen in polyarteritis nodosa and Behçet's disease. They are seen in P. ANCA, they are seen in microscopic polyangiitis, vaginous granulomatosis and Churg-Strauss disease. Next question. Antinuclear antibodies are not found in. Antinuclear antibodies are actually found in SLE. Antinuclear antibodies are found in SLE. Drug-induced lupus, definitely they are found. Diffuse scleroderma also you will see some antinuclear antibody. But in sarcoidosis, you will not see any antinuclear antibody. In limited scleroderma also, we see antinuclear antibody. Antinuclear antibody are completely absent in sarcoidosis. Next question. At 30 years of age, blood-forming bone marrow are found in. At 30 years of age, blood-forming bone marrow is found in sternum, sacrum, pelvis, yes, upper end of tibia, upper end of humerus. All are true. Actually, in adult life, the hematopoietic bone marrow is mainly confined to the central skeleton and also it is confined to proximal ends of femur, tibia and humerus. It is confined to central skeleton and proximal ends of femur, tibia and humerus. Then next question. In which of the following Anka is not, okay, this is same. At 30 years of age, blood forming bone marrow are found in. At 30 years of age, just a minute. Okay. At 30 years of age, blood forming bone marrow was found in, as I have already said, it is found in sternum, sacrum, pelvis, upper tibia and upper end of humerus. Pericardial effusion is seen in all except. Pericardial effusion is seen in uremia. Definitely you will see pericardial effusion, SLE, rheumatic fever and myxedema. In uremia, SLE, rheumatic fever and myxedema, you will see pericardial effusion, whereas hyperthyroidism is not associated with pericardial effusion. Then next question. Epidermal growth factor is found in. Epidermal growth factor is found in platelets and keratinocytes will have epidermal growth factor. Epidermal growth factor is actually produced from platelets, keratinocytes, macrophages and salivary glands also. Next question. Cyclin dependent kinase 2 acts via cyclin A and cyclin E. CDK2 acts via cyclin A and cyclin E. Cyclin A and cyclin E. CDK2 acts via cyclin A in S phase, whereas CDK2 acts via cyclin E in G1 to S transition. Okay, thank you for watching.